That's Holy Spirit speaking to us. So when Holy Spirit spoke to me about the calling that has been placed on our life, and when we answered the call, and this is one of the things that He placed on our heart to do as part of our mission, is to earn the love and respect of the community. He did, not me. He wrote the plan, not me. But when we act out His will in obedience, and this is part of that mission that He placed on our heart, we're acting out of obedience. It's divine. Aho. Amen. Tonight, look, if tonight this message of redemption spoke to your heart, I want you to take a step of faith. God's going to provide gifts. God's going to provide food and drinks. These are good things, but He'll provide much more than that. He'll provide eternal life. Amen. So tonight, whether you've ever dedicated your life to Christ, or you want to rededicate your life to Christ tonight, you want us to pray for you? Take a step of faith. There's no greater gift that we can have than the gift of salvation. I stand before you here today, a healed man from bipolar depression. You may not have thought of that. I was bipolar, manic, depressed. I didn't take medication for it. It was the Holy Spirit that healed me. I had divorce papers written, ready to be delivered to my wife. 13 years of marriage. Ready for divorce. He restored my marriage. I love my wife more than ever. So you think you love greatly, but if you don't have Christ in your life, I tell you something. You don't know how much more you can love others when you have the living God through Holy Spirit in your heart. Take a step of faith. I ask all of those who've been touched tonight in a special way, in an invisible way, God spoke to you. Whether you dedicated your life or not, I want to invite you to the altars right here. And for those who come up, and I encourage you to come up with your children too. Jesus had a great youth ministry. Make no mistake. He said, let the children come to me, as his disciples were saying, no, don't let them go. Don't let them go. He said, no, do not hinder them from me. And He would lay hands on them and pray for them. Seriously, some of us may have come in here tonight. Maybe we had a bad week. Maybe we had thoughts of suicide. Maybe, you know, I've heard so many different things on the native lands. And it's not just the native lands. Trust me, in our inner cities, we got many, many children. Children thinking about committing suicide because maybe they were bullied. There was his name was 12 or 7 Bridges, I forget. But there was a young man who was bullied. I believe he was 12 years old. So I'm just recalling this. So if I don't state the facts completely clear, you understand. This is a young child who put a gun, or I'm sorry, he wrapped his neck and he hung himself. And I remember seeing that, I'm thinking, wow, let me tell you, the devil is a liar. He has come to kill, steal, and destroy. Make no mistake. But the living God, who can live in your heart, He can come and make residence with you. Amen? Jesus says that when you love me, me and my Father will be with you. We'll share a home with you. So right now, I'm just going to leave this moment right now. If God spoke to your heart, and if you've been depressed, if you've been hurting in any kind of way, if you've been, you know, struggling to kick a bad habit, trust me, the Word of God makes it very clear. The world is way too big for us to conquer on our own understanding and our own strength. We need the power of God. Let me tell you something. The devil tries to instill the spirit of fear in us. And it's a lie. It's a lie. God promises when we accept Him into our heart, a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. That wasn't me when I was diagnosed bipolar manic disorder. But I tell you now, I'm clean. I'm white as snow. I know where I'm going. He saved my marriage. He brought me back to my family. I love more now than I ever had before. I have compassion for people when really I didn't have compassion for people back in the day. I was focused on making money and having a big job and traveling. God changed that. That's not what He desired for my life. So tonight, as a man who has been saved by the grace and mercy and power of God, I ask you, step forward. If this spoke to you, you need some healing. You want to believe? Look, I'm only a messenger. I'm only a servant of God. Whatever manifestation takes place, whatever work that He does in your life, it ain't me doing it. And right now, I feel like some of you are feeling Holy Spirit right now because He is pouring out all over me right now. If you feel His presence, come. Come to the altar. And those who come to the altar as a step of faith, God is going to reward you. Make no mistake. The Word says this, that when you come before your brothers and sisters, and you honor me before them, the brothers and sisters on this world, I will honor them in front of my Father in heaven. So if this message spoke to you, I encourage you to come up. And I want all the ministry leaders, I want my pastor, Pastor Hyde, Sean, if you're here, David Boo, the ministry leaders, come up here and be willing to lay hands on those who come up here who need prayer. I need prayer. And even after this, I ask you to keep me in prayer. Apostle Paul always said, look, make no mistake, I need help. The power that comes from up high is not any power that you and I understand or even can fathom, but it's immense, it's great. And He wants to pour that power into your life and heal some things, amen? Now, if you don't need anything, if you don't need anything, right where you're at, you can pray for those who are here. Maybe stretch your hands out. Because as the body of Christ, that's what we do together. We edify and we help to build up. So if all is good, you can stay right where you're at. And you can pray for those who are courageous enough to come up here and humble themselves for prayer. God bless you.
Keep coming, keep coming. Jesus is waiting for you. Is it the time that you make your decision? Not just only for you, for your families, for your kids. Heaven open. Heaven open. And we all want to go to heaven. You're all one family, those who have. Just come and come in. God is waiting. Yes, it's coming.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.